everyone, welcome to our channel. Today we are going to do the water thermometer experiment. Now let us go and make it. Hi everyone, today we are going to make the water thermometer. Is it possible to make a thermometer? Absolutely. The best part about our water thermometer experiment is that you can use the things find at your home. That's right, in no time you will be using the homemade tool to measure temperature. Real thermometers do not use water, they use mercury. Because mercury is dangerous, most thermometers today are used with alcohol. Alcohol is a colorless liquid colored with red dye. Thermometers do not use water because water does not respond to changes very fast. So these are the things we need for the experiment: a glass bottle, normal water, hot water, cold water, food coloring, straw, molding clay, and a marker pen. Let us start the experiment. First, we add a few drops of food coloring into the water. I have already put normal water into the bottle. Next, we take a straw and we pour it inside the bottle. After that, we take molding clay and we wrap it around the top of the bottle and the bottle neck. Then we take the bottle and pour it into the container of hot water. Let us see what happens.
Look at the straw. We can see that the water is slowly rising up.
Let us now transfer it to cold water. Let us see what happens.
We can see that the water from the straw is going down. Let us wait for a few seconds, then we will mark the temperature of the cold water.
In conclusion, in the hot water heats up, though there's more space. The hot water is less dense than the cold water. The opposite is true. As the water cools down and it has lesser space, the cold water is more dense than the hot water. In the hot water, the molecules move faster and the temperature will get higher as hot water expands. In the cold water, the water molecules are moving slowly and it contracts, that's why the temperature will go lower. This cycle is called convection. Thank you.